has to scream it. I don't know what I've been told.
I don't know what I've been told.
Training in Big Bear's really cold.
Training in Big Bear's really cold.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna fib.
Not gonna lie, I'm not gonna fib.
Jake's gonna knock out Big Nose Gibb.
Jake's gonna knock out Big Nose Gibb.
Sound off.
One, two.
Sound off.
Three, four.
One, two, three, four.
You gotta come on with a better one than that.
Yeah, really said.
It's just funny, you know.
It's different. Listen. BJ, how many camps have you been in your life since you started boxing?
I really don't know, to be honest with you. I've been in quite a few. I don't know.
It's not like this. It's a good atmosphere. It's a good vibe. Usually camps are very serious.
Yeah, I mean, we're in a good place right now. Jake's in great shape, and there's really not a lot left to do. Just finishing touches, like Shane said. He's coming in for the landing now. We just want to make sure we don't overwork him. He's already put in a lot of hard work and made a lot of sacrifice. So that will all show on January 30th.
You can't teach power. You're either born with power or you're not.
He has great body mechanics, and the way he throws the shots, the body structure. I mean, he's doing everything right. I mean, he has good hand speed, power.
He listens really good.
Better than a lot of fighters. Like, he'll pick it up, like, the next day. I'll show him something, and maybe he may not get that time.
Hey, familiar, what is that?
We're doing shows February 1st, March 7th.
Okay.
It's Steve Marcano. They're doing boxing shows. Boxing February 1st in Albuquerque, New Mexico. March 7th in Tennessee.
Yes, I did interview the guy. Yeah, that's cool. Impact Network.
Steve Marcano, he's got a bunch of shows. I think almost 30 shows this year, so something to watch out
for. Are you broadcast? What do you think of McGregor calling out Pacquiao? He said, "No,
that's what."
It's all bullshit. You don't just want money. Come on, man. Pacquiao.
He wants to fight for a title.
For who?
For a boxing title. Conor wants to be a boxing champ.
At 147?
I guess. 54.
No, because Pacquiao's 47.
Pacquiao's 47. Mayweather's 47. And Paulie Malignaggi 47. Those are the three names he mentioned.
Yeah, I can see it, you know.
No.
But, it's not realistic to me.
He ain't beating no Pacquiao, Shane. No shot.
He's not beating Pacquiao. Not the same thing. Since I think he needs to fight like one of the regular guys.
Me too.
Would you come back?
Listen, fight somebody like Nico or somebody. You know what I'm saying?
I try. Would you come back for a Conor McGregor fight?
Maybe.
Talk to Tristan about that one.
Yeah, maybe. You know.
Talk to Tristan about that one.
Let's go.
He's a southpaw. He has
Get the call.
Awaken.
We'll see. You know, Dallas could change a lot of things around, I guess. They expect hundreds of millions of dollars.
Why not?
If you do $100 million, I'll be a champ beef there. Right when they say it. I'll be running. You see me running. Duck is moving. Car.
Get that, Elie? Numbers don't lie. 41 out of 49. You are what your record says you are.
Yeah, but it's not only 41, because you look who he fought. That is Fernando Vargas twice.
Yeah.
I mean, Margarito. These are champions.
I fought everybody that was the front man, Rami. You know, so I didn't have no problems fighting anybody. Anytime. It didn't matter what time it was.
You didn't duck anybody.
I didn't duck. I fought, so.
They used to call you the Mexicutioner before Pacquiao.
Can I say why he was?
Why?
He grew up in California fighting all that's what he was used to his whole life. Yeah. Banging people in the body, hitting people in the body. He knew how to fight. Right? Mexico's really good.
No, go straight.
That's the truth. Am I lying, Shane?
Yeah.
It's the truth.
Pomona, right here, down the hill.
We're going to go into town. This is the one. I mean,
is that the one we were in Manchester? We were in Manchester.
Oh snap, I got drunk there.
Yeah, it's like a mile and a half.
I don't know if you're drunk enough.
You want to go
all
the way
back. Yeah, do that 3 miles and go back.
All the way out.
Are we going to have to? Over
yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Fair enough.
I'm trying to place this stuff here, out every day.
You
want to
keep going or what?
Yeah, keep going to the street. And if you guys want to go into the street, it's up to you. I can keep back on the street.
Yeah,
this is better.
Okay.
Go back to where we came.
This is your second run today, right?
Yeah, I did one this morning with Sean already, so. And then we did four rounds of the gym. And we're back for run number two. We got another session at 3, another session at 8 o'clock, so. Wow. Staying busy and it's a lot of fun.
Camp life.
Yeah, man. But this Jake's just chilling right now. Like I said, we've already.
He's not sweating or breathing hard enough.
He's chilling, yeah. He's boxing and sparring the night, so we're just taking it easy. Yeah. We got to pull him back, like Shane said. So.
We don't want to breathe the heart, right?
Yeah. Must sound like, yeah.
That's what it's supposed to be.
Yeah, right? Yeah, definitely.
Oh, this is the high school?
Elementary.
Elementary.
High school is down.
Yeah.
You can feel the high altitude here.
Yeah, especially holding those cameras, Ellie. You're doing better than I thought.
Now, you know who killed me? I went running with Chavez Jr. here. Uh-huh. I did good the first 10 minutes. Then I told him I'll catch you at the end. He works hard.
He can run, yeah.
Chavez runs good.
He can run, yeah.
But Shane, it looks like to me like you're having a lot of fun too here.
Oh, man, this is great. To be involved with the boxing camp, it's fun. Like this, especially with somebody that really wants to box and really wants to learn. Like, that's a great feather for a coach. For any for a fighter, too, just for another fighter, you really want to learn like that. The sport that you love.
He's taking it seriously. It's not a gimmick.
It's not a gimmick. Take it seriously. Like I said, I was trying to hold him back. He just wants to learn.
You can't hold him back.
Just let him go. Go ahead and go home. Send him home.
He wants to go to his natural habitat. Send him
home. Yeah. But that's because we've been working hard every day, and now it's like, yeah. It doesn't feel right if he doesn't work hard. Yep.
That's what we want, though.
And it's good that he has his farm partners there running around like that. Like, that's good camaraderie.
They're professional fighters undefeated. They're really good. Yeah, it's good.
Nico, yeah, professional fighter undefeated. Yeah. The other fighter, I mean, he's pretty good. He's really good, too. So he has a variety of different people. No, he's good.
This hill, I don't know, man. What's the over-under whether our money makes it up? -200, he doesn't make it all the way.
He'll make it.
-200.
I don't know. No, I ain't making that.
No, he ain't making it. -200. That means he's not making it. -200. there we go. Stop.
Done.
He didn't make it. Yeah, okay.
Nah, he gave up.
We make money today. -200, we make it.
And see, Jake got to swim up the damn hill. Look at that.
That's not easy.
No, it's not easy either. If I tell him, just calm down.
You know he's going to score tonight, right?
I know.
Shane, check this out, everybody. Shane told Jake Paul to slow it down. We already lost him. He's somewhere in Big Bear. Hopefully we can find him.
He's at a wrestling bear somewhere. I don't know where he's at.
He's doing a Khabib workout.
Yeah.
You've seen bears here.
I see.
Are they intimidating? Yeah. Or they see him run away?
They don't run away, but they look at you and just keep kind of walking slow by you. Like if you make a wrong move.
They're ready.
Yeah, if you might start charging. So I just stop and let and kind of walk slow the opposite direction.
Shane said if you ever see a little one, just take off running.
Just take off running.
The mom's right.
You see a baby bear? Yeah. Don't
just
even,
take off running.
Don't
yeah.
even buy him.
What happened to your monkey? You still have him?
He's with Anthony.
Okay, he's good.
Yeah, he's good. So Anthony took him up because they can have monkeys in Nevada and our exact animals.
Yeah.
He's great.
Great personality.
Great personality, great little kid. He's like a little kid, you know, it's bad.
Chico, right? What was it? Tito.
Hopefully, Then we go back to Vegas, maybe we get a couple of shots of Tito again.
All right.
You know he locked Shane out of his own house once?
What'd you do to him, Shane?
He was a jokester.
He knew how to lock the door?
Actually, the hotel room. He put the fucking latch on the hotel thing.
Smart.
I couldn't get in with my key. And then I said, Tito, he opened the door. If the guy comes, open the door, he is blinking. So he waited about 10 minutes, oh, and all of a sudden, he said, guy's coming. He jumps up, and I put the key and come in, and then he runs. I chase him. Little fuck.
It's amazing. You told me he would cry with tears, right?
Yeah, he cries. Yeah, I spank him. He'll look at me and have like little tears in his eye.
Bully Shane, come on.
Yeah, he makes
playing on your emotions. Don't be playing.
Oh, okay, Tito, I give a hug. You know.
Damn, they're gone.
They're right there. Those jabs and stuff.
Shane, dirtiest fighter you ever fought?
Miurga.
You fought him twice and beat him twice.
Yeah.
What did he do though? So was it knees? Was it the headbutts?
It wasn't
elbows?
That. He did so much dirty stuff with me. I think that he's the style of fighting. Where he throws overhands and he chews on top of the head. Or
not conventional.
He's chewing the... He just didn't care where he landed. So... I would say it was necessarily dirty with me, but I've seen, you know, the dirt they did, and they did hit me with some overhands. So,
how'd those feel?
He's very heavy-handed.
Heavy-handed, right?
Very heavy-handed in his heart.
Out of all the legends you fought, where do you rate Canelo? Because right now he's a pound-for-pound king, he's the face of boxing.
Where? Out of all of them? I don't know. The legend... I mean, he's up there, but I mean, I don't know how you rate him in the different eras and stuff like that. But he's a complete. I would say he's number one because you know Floyd was up there. Floyd's really smart and good, and then Oscar at the time when I fought him,
yeah,
he was fucking amazing. You know, I think that he's probably the top.
You have Oscar one? At the time you fought him.
At the time I fought him, you know, yeah. He was like the best, one of the best fighters. Yeah, Floyd, you have and then Canelo, at the time of Canelo, I wasn't at my best, so I can't really judge it. And he wasn't at his best either.
Right.
He's still the best. He's still be improving to me.
He's still getting better and better. So Canelo's hard to rate Canelo because he wasn't at his best. I wasn't at my best, yeah. But it's still a great fight. So I can't really rate him.
But it's still a big
what I see, Canelo is like the top person. What I see right now.
Yeah.
You agree?
I do, yeah. I mean, Canelo, I mean, selling out arenas, going from 147 to 54 titles, 60 titles, 68 titles, 175 and beating Kovalev. Even though Kovalev was a little past his best, I mean, he still went up.
Power's the last thing to go.
He still went up, man.
Yeah,
so
hit me that.
You got to give Canelo the respect going up four divisions like that and beating the guy. And then he can do whatever he wants. He's the man. So
man, yeah. He's the real deal. And the fact you put him with the best of the best, the Mayweather, De La Hoya, Pacquiao, yeah. It's a big compliment.
Pacquiao too. He was monster as well. I'm not even sure if I fought Pacquiao at his best, but I fought him.
He's still a monster now, which shows how good he was. You know,
he was, yeah.
Ago. Yeah, like,
how good he really was. Like, yeah. He was fighting like Marquez and
crazy
and Barrera and those guys. I think that's when Pacquiao was probably more of it at his best.
Cotto.
At 130, I mean, Cotto too, but when 40, he was fighting, yeah. He was from 35 to about...
Monster 40, he was really good.
At 40, yeah,
really good.
47, he's a monster too. And he was doing really good.
40,
but I'm saying like 35, 40, like that's when he was, you know, showing up.
Yeah, I think when you have conversation like this, you got to mention Juan Manuel Marquez too,
and Marquez
because
too, yeah.
The fights he had with Pacquiao and Pacquiao's prime, really, it's like
legendary.
One of the best ever, Juan Manuel Marquez.
Yeah,
people always forget about him. But he was so technical, so good, such a sharp puncher.
Marquez, he was great, and he had the advantage. With Pacquiao for the fourth fight because he fought him so many times.
Right.
That's why he was able to get that good knockout. You know what I'm saying? That great knockout because he timed just right.
Shane, how did he gain all that? How did he gain all that weight so good like that, Shane?
Who?
Marquez. You see him in the last fight? I love him. I'm a fan. What do you think?
I don't know how, like, even how Pacquiao gained it like that, Marquez gained the weight, like, you know, I don't know how they could put it on and do that. I mean, I see Canelo's already. He's a young kid, he's a young boy, 154, but he didn't have time to grow.
Yeah.
Those guys are already older, so I don't know. You know, that's, you got to work hard, man. It's kind of hard to do that. I don't know how you put on weight like that.
I don't either.
And put a muscle like that. And he's going for knockouts every time. Yeah. He's trying to fight. He's trying to fucking hurt you.
He'll knock someone out.
If there was social media back then, he'd go viral every day.
Yeah, that's his thing.
Don't make him too upset. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Little touch jabs.
There's a guy that was
John Bray, right?
John Bray. Yeah, the guy that was wrong with him. And as an amateur, I think they did really good with Tyson one time, and then one time Tyson cracked him pretty good. Yeah. Tyson,
hospitalized him.
Yeah.
John Bray was heavyweight, right?
Yeah.
John Bray's heavyweight.
Yeah.
Good heavyweight. He lived in the valley.
They say I still look.
Yeah.
He was working with Robert the Ghost Guerrero.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I live it too, huh? Yeah.
You know.
So Shane, you just did about how many miles? 6 miles right now?
No.
5 miles?
No, not that much.
Three?
That's 20.
We did about three miles.
All right, 3 miles.
But it was easy.
He's not sweating. He's not breathing hard.
I tried to hold him back. He wants to run. So I told the sparring partner to go up there and keep him company because he wants to run. Bad.
Like a deer.
Yeah.
Like a baby deer.
I'm like, come back.
But conditioning.
Why couldn't you make it up the hill?
What do you mean?
The bike.
On it literally stopped going.
When you were going,
I made it up another hill. There was another one that I made it up. Yeah. That was a big hill.
That was.
Damn, Elie, you rich.
No, that's Sean's.
Oh.
It's funny because I came with my wife's car, which is very similar. Jeez. But I'm down at, there was no parking in the morning, so I parked down at, what is it? Jack in the Box? What is down there?
Yes.
Carl's Jr.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Are you parked down there?
Yeah. Well, I didn't. Yeah. There was a truck. It's okay.
Okay.
How do you like working with Shane after all this time?
Man, it's an honor, first of all, but it's just amazing. Like, he pushes me hard. We get in amazing work. And I feel like I'm like, he's like Mr. Miyagi, and I'm like the Karate Kid.
If you played horse, who would win?
Who, me or Shane?
Oh, shit.
Get the basketball out.
We got a ball in the car.
I think the Jake might give me that.
Get the ball really good. Let's see. One shot.
My eyes are not good right now. My eyes are good. I can't
shoot. But you can play.
That means Jake for sure, then.
Yeah,
my okay. Jake has a basketball court in his living room, so I don't know.
You do?
Yeah, he does.
Slash. Actually, I met you the first time at a charity basketball game. It was someone whose game was it? You came in, all the arena chased you back to the locker room.
Oh, Gilbert, that was, I forget, but I know which one you're talking about.
It wasn't Floyd's game, right?
No, it was Arenas.
No. The guy from LA. He went to Westchester High School.
Sam Watson, man?
No. Ariza.
Yeah, Ariza. That starts with A.
Ariza. And you played a Floyd game, right?
I think I played Floyd and with Sam Watson, too, the one right there in it's Playa, right? Playa, yeah.
You're good.
Westchester, yeah. I played a couple games with them, actually.
What's the routine for the rest of the day? So you just did the walk?
So now, he's going to go back and get something to eat, and we're just relaxing until we
chill.
Till later on today, we're going to spar. Some more sparring. So I'm just trying to keep him, right here. Keep him idle until it's time to fight. I mean, he's in tremendous shape. He's ready to go. His speed, power, the movement, everything is looking good. Especially, I mean, we've been here for like a month now.
Yeah.
Maybe a month, yeah.
Maybe more since Thanksgiving.
Yeah. So he's been here for a while. He's been just breathing.
I think Gabe's going to pull out of the fight.
Think so?
Don't say that.
I think he's also. I think he's also gonna fly commercial to get there.
I hope he doesn't.
I'm just calling it now.
He has to receive this ass whooping. Come on, man.
Take the ass whooping, Gib.
Yeah, you gotta receive this. You gotta take it. Take it like a man. Take it like a man. You flew all the way out here. You gotta take it like a man.
I'm gonna bend you over and spank you.
Armani, does he pull out or not?
You know, listen. I think that'd be the worst thing he'd do. He's gonna lose. Everyone knows he's gonna lose. But the best thing he can do is try as hard as he can while losing, to get some sort of respect from
like
somebody.
Deji. That's what Deji did.
Yeah.
He tried really hard while losing. Yeah. So people were like, oh, he was, respect, you didn't get knocked out, but you got TKO'd.
Yeah.
You
give up.
This one might end in a knockout.
Yeah, for sure.
Guaranteed.
Yeah, this is it. This is what we do.
1,000%.
We're going to knock out people. Even if you don't try, it's going to happen.
You see an opening, you go for it.
See an opening, you go for it. But there's so many openings, so.
There's so many openings, so I don't know which one you want. It's like pick one. Like, you got to choose.
It's like a real estate open house. Everything open. No, we got a lot of important stuff to do today, It's like we're booking an extra couple private jets for the homies, furnishing a $10 million penthouse we'll be staying in. reservation and some finishing touches on the $70 million mansion, a couple of yacht parties. Check us out at the Viewtopia Festival. You know, a lot of cool stuff we got planned as soon as Jake knocks it out, after party at 11. So a lot of details to do in between. You know, a couple phone calls, make sure people get to the Jets on time, stuff like that.
We're being Super Bowl weekend, after party is going to be sick with the names there.
No, it's going to be a lituation. The guest list.
There's like 100 celebrities we have coming. So
hopefully they come to the fight too.
Ellen's coming.
Yeah, yeah, no.
They're coming.
Ellen's
coming. Ellen DeGeneres, yeah. Jamie Foxx, all of them.
Who's walking you out? Do you have anybody yet?
Maybe. I can't. I don't
know. Okay, keep it a surprise, people. Yeah. Just tune in to The Zone on January 30th.
Subscribe now. TheZone.com/Jake.
Yo.
Might be a special on that link. Just saying.
All right, go check it out.
You get a discount if you go to that link.
TheZone.com/Jake.
Yep. You might get an invite to the after party. I mean, who doesn't get invited?
He messed up.
If you would have behaved, Gib, like we could have been friends after. Like, part of me like wanted to be friends with Deji, and then,
yo, and you're then Middle Eastern. I was like, we could have hung after this, bro.
Persian. But you misbehaved. We tried to tell you that you, if you just behaved, you could have been friends with us.
But you do want to be friends.
Love you guys. I'll see you Saturday.
Okay. Right, yeah, peace.
Come on, see ya. Jake, Terrell Owens doesn't think your brother has a chance.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, Terrell Owens said, what would he say? It doesn't matter. AB will smoke him.
Terrell Owens can get it next. I said it.
Yeah, that's how Terrell Owens will fight me.
Terrell Owens can get it next.
That sounds like a hell of a fucking co-main event.
Let's get it. Yo, T.O.
He said T.O.
You used to be one of my favorite players, but talking that shit, let's fight. Square up, bro. Put your money where your mouth is. Come on. Those big biceps can't punch you.
Were you going to coach?
Yeah. I've seen him play basketball and baseball.
He's athletic, bro.
He's a good athlete.
He's a good athlete. No one's saying he's not, but don't be,
you know, talking about shit you don't know. You know what I mean?
No, he doubted that your brother ever wrestled. He said he didn't believe that Logan ever wrestled. He goes, I don't believe he ever wrestled. That's what he told me.
I don't know, man. T.O. can get the smoke.
If he
said that, I'll give you the title of this video.
I will. T.O., what about your brother and A.B.?
I mean, it should happen. A.B. doesn't have anything going on. He just got in that, like, police scandal, too, right? You saw that? He's lost. Like, I think he's losing his mind. So I think, like, the fighting would be good for him. And like I said, I told my brother, like, he's never going to play again in the NFL because of the police thing. And he's going to need money, so I don't know.
Next keep this, yeah, don't drive you.
Yeah.
Take the fight, next step.
Take the fight. Sign the contract.
Sign the contract, big boy. Sign the contract.
It's entertainment. This is what it's about, you know.
Sean, check this fight out.
Both good boys.
Conor McGregor, Shane Mosley in a boxing ring.
Conor wants to fight.
The thing is, Floyd's fight was entertaining, but anybody that know fight know what that was.
Yeah.
You know, but you know, somebody applying pressure for the first five rounds, it could have got done early. So.
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah. That's true. So if you want to do it, Conor.
Ooh.
Hey, it's on.
Ooh. Bro, that's hilarious.
I think that Conor said one time when he first fought Floyd, they didn't fight any of the guys that Floyd beat. He'll beat them, and I did make the call. I was like, "Yo, what's up?" But that never happened. Like, he fought Floyd. I understood, you know, more money. But
he had a press conference yesterday. He was very calm. He wasn't the usual Conor.
Nobody fought for that.
Yeah.
You don't buy it?
Be a big mouth anymore. Yeah.
Maybe he's worried he might not win, so he doesn't want to rile people up.
No, I think it's just a mutual respect, man. Like Cowboy, he's like an OG, you know, and like he's respected in sport. So like to talk trash to him, It's mutual respect. I don't think he's like scared or anything like that. I just think he respects him. And most guys do respect Howard.
So Sean has a fight too, right?
Yeah.
You have a fight coming up?
Yeah.
Show you the money.
So thing is gonna happen.
Stop the training. He just kept training. Yeah. I feel in the ring like, man, he's able to fight. I'm impressed. I'm like, okay, because a lot of times people just come in and do the little thing and then they leave, run directly. He's
taking it seriously.
For an hour or two. Getting it in.
I got a little lucky, but right here actually. But
yeah.
It's on the consent board for our show name, buddy. You know what I mean? Flip right here. My man getting busy on these pads.
I like that.
It's not really, you know, can I fight or not, it's just the right time, it's just everything's timing, really.
The right opponent, know. The right situation.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I will fight him and lights out, you know, I'm fighting Marley, but, you know, I don't know, if the opponent was right and the timing was right and it was really happening, yeah, it's like, I got no problems. I love it anyway, so it's not, you know, something I gotta get my mind wrapped around to do, which is, all right, let's go. You know, so.
Tyson Fury or Wilder, who wins?
It's tough, man. It's tough. I like Fury, you know, when he brings to the game, for one, he's like one of the best on the mic. You know, he can talk for days. And he's hilarious.
Hilarious.
And he's entertaining. But, you know, anytime you can punch and have that kind of power in the 11th round for Deontay is, as a heavyweight, man, that's tough. If you can still pack that power in the 11th round like that, that's tough. It's tough to get.
It's a nice round. I mean, you never safe. You know, we'll never safe. It doesn't matter if it's the 12th round and it's 2 minutes, 30 seconds, you gotta be like this, because. So I like Wilder's. I think that he didn't have the amateur background, the background that like Tyson Fury and all those guys had. But he has great athleticism, he has great ability, and his ceiling, he still can get better and better and better. Where the other guys, they kind of reach that ceiling, I think. You know, and they're good, but Wilder as far, but he can still get even better, which is scary.
You know, he only had 30 amateur fights.
Yeah.
He went to the Olympics and won a bronze with no, like, never bought. Yeah.
And that's amazing. That's amazing in itself. And his record is amazing.
43-0 with 42 knockouts and one draw.
And one. Crazy. Come on, man. It's crazy. Come on. That right there, that's a record.
He's a really nice person, too.
Like, very nice person.
Yeah, you get all that. You like
he's very, very real.
Yeah. Lives close by, you know, LA, and he's a regular, not just a regular human being, but he's like he's a person you can talk to. You know,
very down to earth. Yeah.
Yeah, he's really down to earth. So.
Not Hollywood.
No.
Not at all. No, it's great.
So right now, having a little snack.
Yeah, we're having a little snack. Chef Barrows and some stuff for everybody.
Is that your chef, Shane?
No.
Jake Chef.
Jake Chef.
That's not mine.
This is the legend right here.
Yeah,
he's
sorry. Jason, introduce us really quick. What's the name of the chef?
This is Chef Byron. We love you, Chef Byron.
He's professional with the shirt and everything.
This man works harder than anyone. I mean, I actually have an amazing team. Blue works. Everyone works hard, but.
He works really hard in the kitchen. Like, yeah. He makes sure everybody is taken care of. Everybody.
People work hard in the editing room.
Marcos, Armani, working all day. Look at them. He's on a call right now. Tell him we want a million. Tell him we want a million.
We want a million.
All right.
What fight did you, what weight are you fighting at?
It's a catch weight, 187 to 193.
And how are you right now? You're good?
I'm good, yeah, I'm good. I'm cutting a little bit, but I'm gonna come in heavy. I think he's gonna be light. I think he's gonna be like 185, so. Bigger, stronger, faster, better looking.
And it's very important to eat the right food to make weight the right way.
Facts. No,
not to
sure.
struggle or just starve yourself.
No, for sure. For sure. We're coming in right on weight. So I used to cut weight for wrestling, so I'm used to it. I used to cut like 15 pounds. So I'm used to it. But cutting weight, is that back at 15 pounds, 20 pounds? That's the worst.
MMA fighters do those drastic cuts because I know Pantera Rodriguez goes down from 180 to 145. I don't know how he does it.
That's insane.
It is.
That's like what Chavez tried to do, but he's always overweight, huh?
He's one of my favorite people in boxing. He's a really nice person, Julio. But
Junior.
He's a good dude.
He is a good dude. He's a good
guy. Yeah, I've chatted with him like once.
You've met him?
Yeah. Okay. I just don't know how I feel about like the last fight. He either quit.
He was doing really well. He was really outboxing Danny Jacobs, which is not easy. And before the fifth round, or before the sixth.
You think he was outboxing him?
I thought he was doing pretty good.
I thought Jacobs was winning.
I thought Charlie was winning, but it was a good fight though.
Who did you think was winning?
No, I think Jacobs was winning, but I think it was competitive, very competitive.
It was like 3-2 in the rounds, right?
There's 3-2, yeah.
Okay. But I guess he broke his nose.
3-2. Since we're in Arizona, close to Mexico, it's 3-2. Anywhere else is 4-1.
Okay. But Chavez said his nose was broken and he stopped fighting. Okay. But the coroner should be the one taking the blame, not the fighter.
Yeah.
But it happened.
Yeah. I mean, like, you got to give Danny Jacobs credit. He broke his nose, but he couldn't continue. He's got to give him credit.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's part of boxing. It's part of the game.
Yeah.
So.
His nose broke. I mean, Muhammad Ali fought the whole fight. Guys, a jump broke in the second round, I think.
Frazier.
Frazier, yeah.
Frazier broke his jaw.
And he fought the whole fight. So, I mean,
what's the worst injury you played with in the NFL? An entire game.
Torn PCL and LCL.
You can't even walk what you have. You can't stand.
I played in the AFC Championship game with it.
And nobody knew.
Yeah, people knew. It wasn't out there how bad it was. That was the same game that Philip Rivers, he had his ACL still to play. Shit, LT had a knee. Get an MCL.
Just haven't been putting the Irish moss.
Gates had a foot. Sleeves all banged up, so we had to ride.
It seems like all the four players I talk with, there's something, some kind of injury. They always play with this. I don't think it's like part of the game, the sport or something.
Yeah. I mean, you know.
You have to heal. You got ice baths and all that stuff. But still, there's always something.
Yeah.
If you play hard.
There's more concussions in football than in boxing.
Yeah, they broke their whole body.
Yes.
Yeah, with the helmet.
Bigger, faster.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I mean, we're using the arm, which we punch hard as hell, but I mean, for a whole body to rinse with your head, your whole body, that's just different, you know?
Yeah, people be forgetting, like, the helmet isn't necessarily always protection, sometimes a weapon. You know, so you get somebody that's. Say a linebacker is 240 pounds, 235, 240 pounds, and one of 4'5" running into you. And then he uses his helmet.
Like a car wreck.
Feel car wreck, yes. What's crazy?
Yesterday, this thing went viral. Aaron Hernandez documentary on. You were watching it?
Yeah.
Did you see it?
No, I haven't seen it yet. But
did you watch it?
We were watching it on TV. We were just kind of laying back, checking out.
Did you know it?
No. We met a few times. We played against each other, obviously. But I didn't know any of that other stuff. But.
Very tragic story, sad.
Man, yeah, there's a lot of twists and turns in that story that I didn't know about. I was like, whoa, that's crazy.
Yeah.
He was from Connecticut, right? Like New Haven, one of those?
Yeah. Yeah.
They was talking mostly about the CTE.
Yeah.
And, man, you've been around people that, I guess they said the CTE, but the difference in their personality or whatever, I don't know. Yeah. What do you think about that?
I don't know, man. A part of me is saying the person just is the way they are. Maybe the CTE can't control it as much.
Raise it out.
So, you know, if you play any collision sport, you're going to have some kind of head trauma. I don't care what you do. Like, once your brain gets rattled, but that's not an excuse to always go off on the deep end either. So I think that, you know, just if he did have, which I think he said one of the worst cases, that he couldn't really prevent himself or control him from doing all the stuff that he'd been wanting to do. So.
Yeah, but he was popular, a champion, right?
Yeah, which is even crazier because normally when you get in the spotlight like that, you refrain from doing the type of stuff he was doing. And it didn't affect him, stop him doing anything. Yeah.
It's probably like when usually people go out and they have a lot of drinks or whatever, and then they feel more like, oh, I'm gonna, you know, I'll do whatever I want to do.
Yeah.
That's probably what that does.
That does.
Yeah. Cuts up that connection of, you know,
of your senses of
right and wrong. Right and wrong. Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, we've seen boxers that I think have it. And I could see their personality. They act very childish or like things that, like you said, may be in them, but it's not their. There's a guy who passed away a couple years ago. He was from LA. He fought Freddie Roach, but he was acting like a 10-year-old kid whenever you saw him.
Yeah. Oh, I did some boxing.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. I can't think of his name right now. He's Mexican.
Yeah, Mexican. But really, he was like.
Mondo Ramos or something?
No, not Mondo Ramos, but same era.
I know he's just.
But you know what I mean? Like, he was acting like a kid, like a 10-year-old.
Yeah, he could. Because maybe he had a happy-go-lucky type of attitude anyway.
Yeah, it's true.
He was really like, but, fun and stuff like that. And
it just took it
more to that point. Mama, I think it was kind of like it too. More of his acting, like, you know, do like magic tricks and stuff like that. And
then, you're right.
He went out doing that.
Which he should have happened already.
Sad.
After.
But that's the price when fighters pay that nobody sees them. When there's no fans, no money, no attention. They're just left with the damages. So they should set up some fund or something for fighters.
They should. I think it's really good to get back to those fighters that went through the type of war they went through and gave so much enjoyment and pleasure to all the people around the world.
You're right. Inspiration.
The inspiration and stuff. And they gave their hearts. I guess it's kind of like the military thing, too. You go off to war and you come back and then there's new jobs.
Yeah, you're right. They don't appreciate you.
They don't appreciate you. Yeah. The hard work.
But they love you while you fight. Fight.
That's the war right there, man.
You went southpaw, so they're touching you real nice, huh?
What can find that?
160. It's Hurst moving up to 165.
So you're probably walking around at what, 180, 185?
No, probably. Hurst did. Hurst coming up to 47. Yeah, have him out of here.
I don't know how he made 47. He's huge.
Yeah, but he just came from 47 to 60.
Yeah.
He's like, what, 6'2"?
Yeah. Then later, Tommy with the light heavyweight. So then he probably was walking around at 195.
You know? Yeah.
And just as he got older, he filled out.
Man,
look at the height.
We made Hitman.
Yeah. I'm trying to think of Hitman Thomas Hearns.
Is this your favorite fight?
This is my favorite in the war. Especially when I was a kid, bro. Watching him, this is what I refer to, like, you come to fight. This is how you come to fight right here. You're not playing.
You seen that documentary, No Mas? I think it's No. You seen the documentary?
I think
it's a doc. It's a 30 for 30 or something. This out. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy.
But Jamara was my coach for my last fight.
Oh, was he?
Yeah, I had him come out. He coached me. I went to Panama, training out there in Panama with him.
Yeah.
The humidity is crazy, huh?
Definitely.
You change 5 shirts a day.
And he was the hard type of trainer too. Like he liked to
the speed band, the drills, like he's really old school type of coach.
Yeah. You feel the difference in that training?
Yeah, it was different, but me and my bro had the same type of mentality, same style, so I understood what he wanted me to do with the slip by shots, hard stuff. Like a lot of people wouldn't have, it'd be kind of hard for people, wanted to train the people, because they had the same style, but we had the similar style, so we loved training with each other. Like, he loved training with each other, going around and stuff.
Yeah.
You know, he's the only celebrity in his country. No competition. That's it. It's Roberto Duran.
Oh, Roberto Duran.
Yeah. He has his own statue, his own restaurant.
I mean, you can do anything you want to. Well, I was just saying anything, but if I'm with Duran, it's like I just, Duran? Okay.
Go ahead.
Keep going. Yeah. Duran's the president out there in Panama. He actually called the president on the phone. I want to do that. Okay.
Did you know he used to coach Mike Tyson?
Yeah, he was coach Mike Tyson for a little bit, but
Tyson went to Arizona.
Yeah. He said Mike Tyson was doing different stuff, so. Because Duran trains a little different. Different style of training.
Right now, I'm like, okay, we got our meals done.
He trained Sergio Mora too. They sparred. Was it your gym?
Yeah, he was training me, and for that fight, but Sergio Mora, I had him get the ring as far as he wanted to show me what he wanted done. So I said, Sergio, get in there, Larry Brito. Let's see what's going on. And he got it. Yeah, it was actually right there, just get my hair.
That was a good sparring session.
Yeah, recovery. Anti-inflammatory. Speaking of that. Oh, I was in heaven, give me a turmeric shot. Turmeric safer and
Leonard. Sure, great Leonard Marvin Hagler. BJ Flores, who won the fight?
You got him on a